Hey, everybody. A couple of videos back, I showed you this Zebra X701 ballpoint pen. It's billed as a tactical pen. It's got a kind of a pretty nice look to it. We've talked about it in that video, so I'm not going to go back over it. But the reason I bought this pen was I wanted to put it in my everyday carry bag, my EDC bag. Some of you have probably heard of EDC bags, but basically they're just a carrying case filled with everything that you can conceive of that you might need at any given time. Now, this is my EDC bag. It's actually gently used. It's never been on a camping trip or anything like that. I discovered EDC bags a few years ago, maybe like 10 years ago, I'm not really sure. And I was watching the YouTube videos that showed everybody showing off their EDC bags, and I thought, boy, that's the coolest thing. I think I'd like to have one of those. So I bought a bag, much like what I saw other people using in the YouTube videos. And this is made by a company called Maxpedition. 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 And it's green, and it's built. It's very rugged. It's a very rugged bag. It's built very well. Mine is never, it's never been outside, you know, it's never been in the dirt or anything like that. It's been carried around in the console of my cars, mainly when I, you know, take a road trip or something. And in the video where I was showing you the pen, I told you that in a future video I would show you the EDC bag. So here we go. Now, what I have in here might not be what you would have in your bag, because quite frankly I'm not sure if I have a good setup or not. I've never really showed it to anyone. I'm just going to take the things out one at a time and show them to you. Now these are some pills that you might take during a nuclear emergency. It's a thyroid blocking in a radiation emergency. So if you live close to like a nuclear power plant or something like that, and you found yourself in a radiation zone, you can take these pills to kind of help you out. And I'm not going to talk much about it, but you can, they're potassium iodide tablets. Now I live very close to a, you know, I'm downwind from it. I mean, I'm upwind, so. But it's not too far away. It's a very large nuclear power plant. What else do I have? Here's some nylon cord. I've never had to use it. It's still in a package. It's 50 feet. It's a camouflage, you know, camo. But you never know, so. Here's a charger for my iPhone. I robbed the cable, so this isn't much good without a cable. I need to put a cable back into it, so I will. Now, if you needed to purify some water so that you could drink it, you might use something like this. This is a emergency drinking water, germicidal tablets. Okay. Add 2 tablets to 1 quart or liter of water. Okay. Okay. So you put a couple of these tablets in a container of water, and, you know, supposedly it'll make the water safe. There might be an expiration date on here. But I don't see one. So that's good. That's good. Here's some matches. I think they may be waterproof matches. They got kind of a shiny red luster to the match head. And of course, I also have a disposable lighter. Here is a nice razor knife. It's got this nice razor blade type, box cutter type blade to it. Very, very sharp. Very sharp. I think I picked that up at Lowe's years ago. A backup lighter, just in case. Here's a knife sharpener. Don't see a pocket knife in here. But if you were going to sharpen a blade using it, just put it in here like this and do this. I can already tell that it's working. These knives are, most of you have seen this one, this little blue one. Does it look familiar? This is the one I usually carry. I like it a lot. It's nice green. Copper lock case. I have this nice knife here. Three blades. So I need to put a appropriate pocket knife in here, I guess, sometime. Unless this tool, maybe this multi-tool has a blade on it. It's been a while since I've looked at it. So how do you work it? Okay. It's been in this bag for years. I had to refamiliarize myself with it. But I think it does have a knife blade. Oh yeah. Yeah, it's got a knife blade. It's got other blades too. It's got screwdrivers. I see 3 flathead screwdrivers. A Phillips head screwdriver. A can opener. And of course, pliers. It's got a ruler in centimeters on this side, and inches on this side. It's pretty nice. It's one of those things though, you know, I bought it, put it in this bag, and never used it. Oh, here's another lighter. I don't think you're gonna have too many of these disposable lighters laying around. And this is the type of lighter that you would need in an emergency. You wouldn't use lighters like these Zippos. This one's kind of got a steampunk looking. Because a Zippo, you know, needs lighter fluid, and they dry out, and you're always having to put lighter fluid into it, so you have to pull this out. And then you have to put the fluid into this absorbent sponge. So, I actually have 3 lighters in here. That's probably overkill, I guess. That's the knife sharpener. Here's some tweezers. And I do remember that I did use these one time. I was glad that I had them with me. So it's got a magnifying glass on it. That way you can kind of see what you're doing. Those are nice to have. How do you uncap it? It's got a nice pointy Phillips head on it. And this end is a flat head. So you can just turn it around and use whatever end you want. Same thing on this end. Slightly larger screwdrivers. And maybe that's overkill because it's kind of redundant, because this multi-tool has a screwdriver in it. Here's a Sharpie. And some hand sanitizing spray. Here's a big clothespin. And an emergency whistle. It's pretty loud. There's a magnifying glass, 10 power, 21 millimeter element, and you can actually start a fire with this. You can use it to focus the light from the sun into a pinpoint so hot that it will ignite the paper. Or wood. Here's a compass. And north is that way. Here's a pocket first aid kit. You can clean up a wound. Remove slivers. Got some anti-infection ointment in it. You could treat some blisters or insect bites or bee stings, that kind of thing. I've never had to get anything out of here. I do have a larger first aid kit that I carry in the trunks of the cars. And here's a packaging that came with a knife sharpener. In the front, I have a nice Fender guitar pick. You never know when you're going to need that. It's a pretty one, too. It's nice. It's a beautiful blue pick. it's not quite as beautiful as my favorite one. If you know me, green is my favorite color. Just look at that baby. Is that beautiful or what? Very nice. You know, really, it's these small things that they're simple, but I can appreciate it. I can appreciate the beauty of this simple guitar pick. So both colors are beautiful. I like the blue. I don't like it as much as the green. Tell me in the comments which one you like best. I have some other picks in here. This one's pretty old. Here's a Clayton pick. It's got the eagle on it. Here's a nice green Jim Dunlop pick. Here's a Fender. It's just black. Here's a Klutz pick. Here's another Clayton, smaller. And a Gibson Heavy. And the last thing in here is just a flash drive. You never know when you might need that. It's only 4 gig. That kind of tells you how old it is. These days, most of them that you buy are going to be like 64. So, anyway, I guess that's it. Oh, yeah, the pen. So, after I bought the Zebra tactical pen with the intention of putting it into the Maxpedition bag, I realized I already had a pen in there. It's a one of those Fisher space pens. I actually forgot that I owned one of these space pens. I don't remember buying it. I don't know where it came from. So... I'm not sure. Maybe I've got three lighters in there. Maybe I should take a lighter out. Have two lighters and perhaps 2 pens. I don't know. I'm going to have to think about it. Oh, I'm getting sleepy. So, I'm not going to put the stuff back in the bag right now. I'm probably going to do a little research and see what people are keeping in their bags these days. See if anything's changed in this regard. If you have one of these type of bags, what do you keep in yours? And if there's something missing from mine, and I know there is, tell me what I should add to it. So I appreciate you watching this video. And until next time. Take care.